It's been a long while since something boiled my prunes enough for me to write and or record a big long rant about it, but I've waited for months on this one. If the big name dinosaur gaming YouTube channels aren't going to speak up about the disaster that is Mesozoica, then as a no-name channel with a loud opinion, I'm going to. I'm months late to the punch, and still it hasn't blown up like I think it should. Full disclosure, I am not, nor have I ever been, a fan or supporter of Mesozoica. I watched its beginning, I watched its rise to popularity through certain dino gaming YouTubers, and I watched its fall from grace. From the very beginning, I knew that any fundraising campaign it tried was bound to be a scam, and I tried to warn people away from giving the devs their money. But why was I so convinced? Why did I try to discourage people from supporting the development of a game that seemed to be what they'd been waiting for? To explain that, I want to take a look at where Mesozoica's development began, and who is behind the Kickstarter scam where it ended. Gather round, children, Grandma's gonna tell a story. Once upon a time, in the ancient days of the early 2000s, Jurassic Park 3 was released to mixed reception from critics and audiences alike. To this day, it remains the most divisive entry in the Jurassic Park franchise, with virtually no middle ground to be found between the people who think it was a cinematic masterpiece and people who think it was garbage. It spawned more than a decade's worth of arguments over whether or not Tyrannosaurus or Spinosaurus would win a fight. It also spawned a buttload of games, many of which were actually quite memorable. One of these was Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. JPOG, as it is often affectionately referred to as, started development in 2001 and saw its release in 2003. It was a video game experience equivalent to capturing lightning in a bottle. Even though the game was a relatively unpolished Dino Park simulator at launch, and was released unfinished to average reviews, you would probably be hard-pressed to find anyone who actively dislikes JPOG. When you consider the fact that the PC release has proven easy to mod, with a modding community that is still making new mods 15 years later, it's safe to say that it's one of the most well-loved Jurassic Park games that has ever been made. Fast forward to the early 2010s, and fans are unhappy with the fact that a sequel to JPOG has never been planned or announced. The developers, Blue Tongue Entertainment, had closed down in 2011, and Universal kept quiet whenever people asked about it, meaning that it was highly unlikely that we would ever see a JPOG 2. JPOG, meanwhile, was beginning to show its age, even with dedicated modders continuing to try and update the graphics and AI. People were developing an itch that just wasn't being scratched. Enter Jurassic Park Operations. This was the first name that I heard the game referred to by, but given how many iterations the project went through after it came to my attention, it may well have had a different name to start with. The team that was working on it promised something very exciting, a true sequel to the JPOG experience, with more dinosaurs and more ways to customize your park. Basically, Jurassic Park Operations set out to be what the offspring of JPOG and Zoo Tycoon might have been. People were excited to see a team doing what it seemed at the time Universal wasn't interested in doing. Me being one of those people, I decided to keep an eye on the project's development. The world being the way it is, it wasn't long before things hit a speed bump. The team wasn't affiliated with Universal, and thus didn't have the rights to make a Jurassic Park game. When warned to stop what they were doing, Jurassic Park Operations ceased to exist, and the team quietly dissolved. Just kidding. They reposted everything they'd already had under a new project name, Jurassic Park Genetics. Faced with the fact that a mere warning wasn't going to cut it, Universal put on its big boy pants and served the project a cease and desist order. So, the team was faced with an uncomfortable reality. They could not keep doing what they were doing, and so could not promise a true JPOG sequel. So what was their next move? Enter Indiegogo and the title Jurassic Genetics. Amid a growing list of proof that the models and other assets Jurassic Genetics was using were stolen, not just from JPOG itself, but from the Stomping Land and other various artists, the campaign failed. Other people have already gone into huge amounts of depth exploring all of the stolen assets, so I won't go into too much detail here. I'll put links to the relevant posts in the description. The part of it all that I will get into is that by the time Jurassic Genetics was rebranded Jurassic Planet, there had been several schisms in the original team and two more projects had begun. Prehistoric Kingdom, which set out to deliver on the promises Jurassic Park Operations had made, and Mesozoica. Now, I'm not 100% clear on which project began first, or what happened behind the scenes, because I was just a bystander watching all of this shit go down. To the best of my understanding, first the Prehistoric Kingdom's team split from Jurassic Genetics, and then the Mesozoica team split from Prehistoric Kingdom. The timeline of events, however, isn't quite so important as the outcome, so whether or not I'm wrong on these counts is a moot point. This is where the controversy continues, and the question of legality crops up more often. Mesozoica, from its conception in 2014, faced a rocky beginning. Another dinosaur park project that had already been in development for 2 years also sported the title Mesozoica. When the creator of this project, Donald Rittenbach, reached out to the team behind the newer project, he was told by Max Wood to take it up with their lawyers. The team claimed the title Mesozoica was registered to a company by the name of Underdog Interactive LLC, which was later found to not only be a completely unrelated name, it's not even registered as an LLC. Max then blocked Donald, making it clear that he didn't give a shit about what Donald's concerns were or what he had to say. One of the other biggest sources of controversy during Mesozoica's development has been Robert Fabiani, the creator of the game's creature models. Paleoenthusiasts were disappointed by the fact that he would include inaccurate dinosaur skins and models, such as the Jurassic Park depiction of Spinosaurus and Dromaeosaurus and Tyrannosaurus without feathers. Robert Fabiani was insistent that all of his models were completely scientifically accurate when they suffered from problems such as shrink wrapping, pronated forelimbs, and other inaccuracies. When confronted on these issues, Fabiani is inclined to double down and defend his work instead of listening to the constructive criticism. In addition to his models not being as accurate as advertised, Fabiani has a history of unprofessional conduct. In October of 2015, the newly discovered and described Dakotoraptor was revealed in a scientific publication. This creature, however, had been teased as the dragon by Fabiani for months. A month before the paper was published, Fabiani leaked the full model of the creature, and in the days leading up to the publication, he leaked details about the creature that should not have been known to the public yet. This was a breach of an embargo put on the information, and a breach of the trust the writers of the paper put in him when they gave Fabiani the details. Fabiani then boasted of how his Dakotoraptor was highly accurate, despite the model he'd created having several inaccuracies. When these were pointed out, the comments were deleted and the people who posted them blocked. Fabiani then proceeded to update his Dakotoraptor in an effort to shut down the criticisms of his work, and made the claim that the critics were haters and that no paleontologist involved with the project had an issue with it. Before we move on to why Max Wood is such an abysmal example of a human being, I have one more, admittedly somewhat personal gripe to add about Fabiani. He has a bad habit of taking creature designs from other media. Jurassic Park 3, Dinosaur Revolution, and Walking with Dinosaurs are just a few examples of this. One of the stolen designs was probably only indirectly stolen because it was a backer skin based on a popular JPOG Tyrannosaurus skin. The only reason I know it was used without permission is because the creator of the character, Crusher, is my significant other. There is reason for me to believe none of the RIP designs were used with permission because nobody contacted Crusher's creator for permission to use the skin. When trying to get in touch with Fabiani about this, my partner found that the skin no longer existed, with Fabiani claiming that things got deleted. This incidentally falls in line with backer rewards being unlikely to ever see the light of day, given recent events, or lack thereof. Now, I mentioned a little of Max Wood's scummy behavior earlier, but it's important to understand exactly how much of a piece of shit this guy is. For all of the problems that I have with Fabiani's conduct, I have to make it very clear that Max Wood is the man behind the scam. If you ever see a project with his name attached to it, do not trust that project with your money. Not only did he threaten to sue a man when he didn't have a legal leg to stand on, after Mesozoica raised $55,000 during its Kickstarter, he took the funds and ran, reportedly leaving the rest of the development team unpaid and the promised Kickstarter backer rewards undelivered. According to him, all Kickstarter promises have been fulfilled. As of me writing and recording this, the last update to the Kickstarter was in January of 2018, about a week after the game launched on Steam, and there has been radio silence from Woods since. The most significant recent update was in June. It came from a moderator of the Mesozoica forums who claims that the game has gone on a development hiatus and expresses their condolences for the Kickstarter backers. There is no sign that there will ever be any further updates to the game, or that the team that worked on it or the supporters will ever see the compensation they should. Truthfully, the backers have my sympathy too. Mesozoica is a good hard look at the fact that not every campaign creator has the best intentions. 55 grand is not an insignificant amount of money for a developer to run away with, and that's not even taking into consideration any additional revenue from Steam sales. It sickens me to know that the people who pledged hundreds or thousands of dollars will never see a finished product or a refund. And I am angry and deeply disappointed that none of the big names that endorsed Mesozoica are speaking out about this now. I have seen a grand total of 2 or 3 videos calling Mesozoica a scam, and they collectively only have a few thousand views between them. The big names should be out there calling a spade and helping to bring attention to this. Who cares if it means admitting that you made a mistake, that you fucked up? You jumped on Mesozoica's Kickstarter and gave Maxwood the ability to steal from people. From hundreds of people. The least you can do for these people is to put the word out there that you made a mistake and put your faith in the wrong campaign. You can help get the word out there about what a scumbag this guy is. You're right there on top of getting your viewers to spread the word when there's a new indie campaign you're excited about. Why is it any different when you can prevent more damage from being done? You all know who you are. And you all should have been the first to be talking about this.